Hello students, welcome to Biosmart Academy. So in this video I am going to discuss about CSIR life science question. This will be the part 3 of the video. Already part 1 and part 2 I have already uploaded it, so please go and check that videos. So here also I am going to discuss some of the question that has been asked in the CSIR life science examination. Okay, so as I already mentioned, all these questions I collected and I try to solve, and I try to predict that this should be the answer. So you can check it, and we have to wait until the final paper and answer key are released. So in this video these questions I am going to discuss. So this is the first question on geological time scale. Actually they asked this time I think 3 or 4 questions from geological time scale. Okay, so in my previous video I discussed about one question on geological time scale. Okay, so this is the first question. So they given this order and they asked that which order is the correct one. So in point of geological time scale, so this is the correct order: yon, then era, then period, then epoch. So I feel that this answer will be the correct one. You can match according to your answer. Now another question they asked from the chlorine ion. Okay, so they asked that how many that chloride ions is around one sodium in NaCl lattice. Okay, so basically if we see NaCl, so it is a somewhat crystal like structure. Okay, crystal like structure, and it is crystal like structure, and in NaCl crystal like structures, so if we see NaCl, so this Cl is mainly present on 8 corner and plus 6 in face center, while Na is present 12 on the edges of the center, and plus some are present in the center of the cube. So the correct answer for this, and the coordination number is 6:6, so the correct answer for this question will be 6. Correct answer will be 6. Okay, now next question. So next question is that to distinguish between alpha helix, how can you distinguish that the alpha helix, pi helix, 310 helix, these structures. Okay, so this can be easily distinguishable by near UV CD spectroscopy. So this will be the correct answer: near UV CD spectroscopy. So these are the correct answer for these 3 questions. Okay, now another question they give this match some pairing type of question where they asked about this. So African lungfish estivation, monarch shows bat cell mimicry, this is also correct. Crystal jelly is bioluminescence, and coral snake, this is not aposematic, this may be. So there is a problem with this question, we don't know. We have to wait for the original question paper and answer key, then we can understand the question. Another question they asked on the cleavage part. So as you know, the central acetal cleavage is for the insect, mesolacetal cleavage is for amphibia, telolacetal is for bird, and isolacetal is for tunicate. These things we are reading from zoology or from any life science background. All students are reading all these things from BSc level. So this is very simple question. I hope you correct it. Okay, so these are the answers for these 2 questions, but we have doubt in this question. Okay, so we have to wait for the original question paper as well as answer key. When it released, I will try to discuss the questions. Now, so what is plasmodesmata? So basically one question is mainly came from plasmodesmata. So these 2 options should be correct regarding to this question, that simplast occur through plasmodesmata. As you all know, that simplast is mainly passes through that plasmodesmata region, the connecting region. Okay, and transmembrane transport occur through tonoplast. Okay, so these 2 options should be the correct option for that plasmodesmata question. I don't have the whole question, so but if you remember the question, then you can know that this should be the correct answer. And I think one question is came from Dixon plot. So what is this plot? So basically this type of plot is mainly occur to measure the enzyme inhibition with dissociation constant. Okay, in enzyme inhibitor complex, enzyme inhibitor complex. So type of enzyme inhibition and dissociation constant for an enzyme inhibitor complex. So this plot is used. Okay, so students, so these are the sum question. So this that I discussed in today's video, and this is my final video for the CSIR NET memory sum questions that I discussed here. I already discussed some questions in my part 1 and part 2 of the video. This is the final part, that is a part 3. So if you combine, if you watched all these 3 part of my videos, then you will get maximum number of questions. Okay, so now when the question paper is released, then that time we will try to discuss the questions. Okay, till then we have to wait for the question paper, we have to wait for the answer key. So student, I hope you will get benefited from all these videos that I uploaded and try to discuss the question as much as I collected and get. Okay, so if you like, then please subscribe. Thank you.